Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1971. VLOOKUP to sum the entire matching row. Well, hey, I just finished doing a seminar for the Australia region of Excel for Apps. Now, I'm pretty excited. If you happen to be watching this here in February, I'm going to be heading down to do my very first seminars in New Zealand and Australia, March 3rd through 11th. If you're in Auckland or Sydney or Melbourne or can get there, you'll want to check this out, excelsummitsouth.wordpress.com. A whole bunch of people, Charles Williams from the UK, John Peltier, Ken Pools, a whole bunch of Excel people will be doing 2 days of seminars in each city. And so I was doing the seminar webinar in advance of that, talking about VLOOKUP, and Fabian asked this brilliant question. He says, look, I want to do a VLOOKUP here for A102, and when I find the match, I want to add up all of the numbers in that row, okay? And this is going to be really, really, I'm going to say tricky or clever, I don't know. First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to do a match to figure out where A102 is in the list. So, equal match A102, and there's our set of answers. We want an exact match, so comma zero, which is like doing a comma false at the end of VLOOKUP. And A102 is in the second item of that list. But as we copy that down, you know, it's going to be in other places. Press F4 there. Double click to copy that down. All right, so get rid of those NAs. All right, so that tells us where the answer is going to be. And I'm going to use something very unusual here. I'm going to do something called equal index of the January column. Press F4 1-2 times to lock it down to the row. And where do I want? I want the second item in that range of values. Okay, now normally, if I would just press Enter here, the index is going to return a 3 because that's the value found for A102. But I'm not going to just press Enter here. I'm going to put a colon. All right, and this is a very unusual use of index. When you follow an index or precede an index with a colon, instead of returning the value that's found there, what it's going to return is the cell address. It's actually going to say that this is L5 is where it's found. And so then I'm going to ask for the index of all of the December values, the last column. Press F4 twice. And what do we want? We want the answer from column B. All right. And this amazing function is going to actually say, hey, we want everything from L5 to W5. Now, in the past, I would have done this with an offset function. But offset, it's a volatile function. It's a very, very slow function. Index does not suffer from this problem. Since this is returning 12 cells, I'm going to pass it to the sum function. And closing paren. I don't need Control Shift Enter. I just enter the answer, double click to shoot that down. Let's do a little test here to make sure that this is working. So we pull these values here from A102, and sure enough, 46. All right, so beautiful, beautiful little formula there using this really strange use of index that has a colon after it or before it in order to force those to change into actual cell addresses. Here, to show you what I mean, I'll choose that cell and we'll do evaluate formula. And we'll evaluate right here. This is where it's about to do the index, and normally it would return the value that's there, but because it has a colon after it, it actually returns the cell address. And here again, returns it. So that's actually, those indexes are changing into cell addresses. Really, really cool use. I learned that from Dan Mayo, who was on the question team for the Model Off group. Dan showed me that at one of the former Model Off World Modeling Championships, and I was like, that is a clever use. All right, so hey, I want to thank Fabian from Australia for sending that question in. I want to thank you for stopping by. And if you're in Australia or New Zealand, I hope to see you here in a couple of weeks when I come down for the Excel Summit South. Thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.